Hello, dear students. Once again, I am here to present you about the oscillators, which is unit number 5 of the subject analog electronics of this electrical engineering as well as electronics and telecommunication engineering branch. Today we will discuss about this oscillator. Let us continue it, and before continuing it, once again I am introducing, I am Lalit Kumar P. Bhaiya, Associate Professor in Bharati College of Engineering and Technology, Durg. Let us go ahead. Here, oscillator. We will see the introduction of the oscillator, then linear oscillators, Wien bridge oscillator, RC phase shift oscillator and LC oscillators. And then we will go for the stability. What is the oscillation? You are already known. For example, the sinusoidal wave, you are already known. Sinusoidal wave is nothing but the oscillations. Oscillation is an effect that repeatedly and regularly fluctuates about the mean value, is called as the oscillations. And the circuit which produces such type of oscillation is called as an oscillator. In another way, you can say oscillator is a circuit which generates the particular waveform, generates the particular oscillations. And already we have seen in the last chapter, that is feedback amplifiers. The feedback amplifiers requires the negative feedback, while this oscillators requires the positive feedback. Oscillator uses the positive feedback to produce the oscillations, while feedback amplifier requires the negative feedback to have the proper desensitivity of the gain. Here in oscillators, we will also learn the characteristics, wave shape, frequency, amplitude, distortion, stability, etc. Then we will go through the applications of the oscillators. Oscillators are used to generate the signals. This is the basic thing. Used as a local oscillator to transform the radio frequency signals to the intermediate frequency signals in a receiver. Then used to generate the RF carrier in a transmitter. Used to generate the clock signal in digital systems. And used to sweep the circuits in TV sets and CRO. In TV sets for sweep circuits, these oscillators are used. These are the some linear oscillators. Wien bridge oscillator, RC phase shift oscillator, LC oscillator and its stability. And as already you know, the structure of the feedback amplifier, in which we use here this feedback as a negative feedback. In oscillator, the same type of structure is there with a positive feedback. This is the input which is positive shown here, and this is also positive. Hence, there is no phase difference between these two. This is called as a positive feedback. Here the amplifier which has the open loop gain A, and this is a frequency selective circuit, or you can say feedback network which has the feedback factor beta. This is output and this is input. This is the feedback voltage and this is the signal to the amplifier. This is called as a positive feedback. For sinusoidal, input is connected linear, because the output is approximately sinusoidal. A linear oscillator contains a frequency selection feedback network, which is shown here, and amplifier to maintain the loop gain at unity. This so that loop gain A beta will be maintained at the unit. This is the condition of the oscillator. Then for the oscillator, you know, feedback amplifiers, you know, the closed loop gain is given by V naught upon Vs is equal to A upon 1 plus A beta. While for this oscillators, this V naught upon Vs is equal to A upon 1 minus A beta. For feedback amplifiers, we have this factor is 1 plus A beta, and for oscillators, we have this factor as this factor as 1 minus A beta. So this is the difference between oscillator circuit and feedback circuit. And this oscillator should have the condition loop gain A beta should be equal to 1 and the angle between A beta should be equal to 0. These two criteria should be maintained. This is called as the Barkhausen criteria of the oscillator. Barkhausen criteria should be maintained by the any oscillator circuit. Here, the Wien bridge oscillator. This is the Wien bridge oscillator circuit where this is the frequency selection components R1 C1 and this is R2 C2. The connection is in such a way, this is impedance 1, this is impedance 2. Impedance 1 is in series while impedance 2 is in parallel. So this frequency selection network is connected along with this Wien bridge oscillator circuit. Here, this is the characteristics of the Wien bridge oscillator and the feedback factor beta shown here. Barkhausen, how the Barkhausen criteria is maintained, you can have this A beta is equal to 1, and this is the example to maintain this Barkhausen criteria, and this is the circuit diagram of the Wien bridge oscillator using the operational amplifier. This is the op amp, this is the Wien bridge circuit, this frequency selective component 1 and 2 where both components are same, RC, and this is the feedback network RF and R1, and here we will get the RF by R1 is equal to 2 in this case particularly because these components are same here. This is the RC phase shift oscillator. Here 3 networks are there of RC, 1 RC, 2nd RC, 3rd RC, each will provide up 60 degree and total will be 180 degree and 180 degree will be provided by this amplifier. So to around the network complete 360 degree. So there is no phase or 0 degree you can say, no, there is no phase shift and this will complete the Barkhausen criteria. RC phase shift network, this is the general description. Here condition is that this omega frequency is given over 1 upon square root 6 RC and beta is equal to minus 1 by 29. This is the criteria which we obtained from this 3 RC phase shift network. And then in next slide we will discuss about the LC oscillators. Thank you.